Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to customize the look and feel of invoices, sales receipts, and estimates. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now, or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. Customizing the style and appearance of your invoices will give them a more professional look than just the standard default sales forms. The default QuickBooks forms are not very professional looking and may not contain enough space for your customer information. It's important to customize sales forms because they are a reflection of your business. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. To begin, after you have signed into your QuickBooks Online account, go ahead and click on the gear icon and select Account and Settings. Click on the Sales tab. At the very top is the Customize section. Go ahead and click on the Customize Look and Feel button. On the next screen, you want to go ahead and click on the blue New Style button in the upper right-hand corner. This screen brings us to the Customize Form Style, where the magic happens. The first thing that you want to do is select the form that you would like to customize. To do this, just click the drop-down and select a form. Invoice, Estimate, or Sales Receipt are the options here. There are five areas that QuickBooks allows you to customize for business sales forms: style, appearance, header, activity table, and footer. In the style section, we have five templates to choose from. Airy is the default template, modern, fresh, friendly, and bold. Each template differs in formatting, the number of fields, and the type of fields that appear on the invoice. In the appearance section, you can change the look and size of your logo, where your logo appears on the invoice, either the left side, the center, or the right. You can set the font for your invoices here. You can set the height on the body of the invoice. This is important if you have long product or service descriptions. Page margins can be set here if you use custom letterhead that is not the standard 8.5 by 11 size paper. In the header section, you are able to change the name of the form. So for example, if you prefer to call an estimate a quote, you can actually change it right here. Company information allows you to select what information you want to appear on your invoices. So for example, we have company name, we have email, address, website, and phone number. Customer information allows you to have payment terms and due dates show up on all invoices. You don't want your customers to have to guess when payment is due. Finally, the custom fields section will only be applicable if you have created custom fields in QuickBooks that you want to appear on sales forms. In the How to Set Up Sales Forms content video, we discussed why you might want to create custom fields and how to do this in QuickBooks. To access this course, just click this link. In the Activity Tables section, you can select the columns that appear on your invoices and the order in which they appear. For example, since Paul bills by the hour, we will go ahead and change the quantity field to hours. In the footer section, you can include a brief message to your customers on each invoice, like "We appreciate your business." There is also a place to enter information that you would like to appear at the very bottom of each invoice, like your website. As we make changes in each of these areas, we can do a print preview at any time to see what it looks like. Print preview is located at the bottom part of the screen. Let's go ahead and take a look at our custom invoice that we've created for Paul. Once you are satisfied with the form, we can go ahead and save it. When we get to the save screen, we will also need to give it a name. So for Paul's invoice, we'll call it Paul's Custom Invoice. In order for Paul to use his new custom invoice, he must make it his default. To do this, we want to go ahead and click on the arrow to the right and select Make Default. That wraps up the lesson on how to customize the look and feel of your invoices, sales receipts, and estimates in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online.